What is the difference between a blog and a newsletter? They're both tools that you can use to build your business and your brand. Your blog is something that lives on your website where you write periodically and hopefully consistently, hopefully at least once a week, about your products and services. Now you can also use your blog to grow your brand in other ways. So for example, if you make vegan soaps, you could write about the vegan plant-based lifestyle. I'm sure that would be interesting to the same people who want to buy vegan soaps. Or if you write about health and wellness, you may want to share the latest news and tell people how they can incorporate these tips into their own lifestyle. A blog is out on the internet for all the world to see. So what you want to do is optimize it for search engines so that people can find you. So when they're interested in the topics that you write about, they'll find you in Google and Bing or other search engines. And that way you build up authority on the web. Now, a newsletter is you're writing to an audience that already knows who you are. So your blog you're using to find new people and, you know, to also write to the people who know you. But on your newsletter, you definitely have an audience who opted in to give you their email address and gave you permission to write to them. So it's a perfect opportunity for selling your products and services. Now, you don't want to do that all the time because it would be spammy. But if you use the 80-20 rule, 80% of the time, your newsletter should be informative, entertaining, just full of your personality. And 20% of the time, you can try to sell your products and services. And that's the biggest difference between a blog and a newsletter. Your blog, you can use to find new people and to entertain your audience. Your newsletter is people who already know you. So that's why on your blog, you always want to have a call to action to where people can sign up for your newsletter. So when they find you through the search engines and they like what you have to say, they like your blog, they give you their email address, and then you've captured them as a potential client or a potential customer. So that is the biggest difference. When you get them to your newsletter, you're getting them one step further into the process and one step further down into your sales funnel. I hope this helps. If you have any questions, please leave any comments or questions below, and I will be glad to answer them. Bye.